Hello, I'm Georgia Groome, one of the actors in Double Dates.
Georgia, fantastic to have you here at Fright Fest. What does it mean for you to be a part of this year's festival?
It's exciting. I think I've been here before, but I'm not sure I have. So it's fun. It's nice to be somewhere that kind of celebrates a fun genre of film. So that's good. So I play Lulu, who is one of the sisters of the film. And she's kind of owned, I guess, by her older sister Kitty, and is embroiled in Kitty's master plan. It's hard not to say it without spoilers, but she's kind of probably a bit beaten down, but also has, you know, she's doing it. She's pretty badass and gross. And it was nice reading it to see a character that was kind of written really strongly, and they're so there on the page. Danny's writing so good that it kind of instantly came to life, and the relationship between the girls as well. And just seeing how it felt like they were strong as opposed to being an object of the male gaze or anything like that. So I was read it and was straight in.
The horror genre does sometimes get a bad rap for the cliche of having women as victims and men as the danger. Was it nice to find a project like this that deliberately and consciously subverts that narrative?
Yeah, and really exciting. You read so much stuff and you see so much stuff where that's not the case. And I think especially with horror as a genre, you're ready to see kind of the girl covered in blood going, ah, and running for her life. And in this, it's completely reversed, which is just really fun to play with because it's funnier, actually, to see men running for their life and screaming and crying. So that was really nice and quite exciting. And I think, you know, my favourite type of horror films are the ones where they are a bit slapstick and funny. And even if you look at kind of Shaun of the Dead, not that it's a horror film, it's that kind of vibe that I really like. So to see that on the page, but also to see it subverted, was just really cool. And I think they did a good job of getting that from page to screen as well. And the team, you know, mainly there was the four of us actors, and Michael Socker, who's not here today, is one of the, I mean, they're all very funny, but Michael is horrifically funny. And I've known him since we were like five. He would have been a bit older. So to get to work with Michael was a dream because it's been a long time coming. And just, I think when there's four of you and there's not that many kind of people coming in and out, you get to know each other really well. And kind of we got to improv, and, you know, Ben, director, was really good at letting us do that. So you just end up having a bit of a laugh, which makes it nicer. So we were on 3 weeks of night shoots, which painful. You know, you don't see anybody else in your life for those 3 weeks other than the people you're working with. So it was really nice to kind of have a small team, a young team. Most of the crew were kind of young. We had a female DOP, which is still pretty unheard of. So that's super exciting to kind of have her there and leading the crew, really. That everyone just had a great time. I know that sounds like a cliche, but it genuinely was quite funny to make. Well, I think horror, the nice thing about horror is that people still go to the cinema to watch it. I'd never sit and watch a horror film on my own. I like to have other people to bounce off. So I think Fright Fest has given people a chance to kind of have their film seen on the big screen where they might probably not. And it's a genre that kind of brings people together, I think.